Yeah. Okay. So as you know, our lesson is interactive. I hope that all of you watched already the lecture on differentiation, because our lessons, it's a flipped classroom, are based on the lectures. Okay. You can raise your hand. You can raise your hand if you watched the lecture. I want to see a general picture. Please raise your hands who already watched the lecture, and I hope that next time it will be 100%, because it's heavily based on the lecture, on the pre-recorded lecture. Okay. The topic of the lesson today is derivatives of multivariate functions. I also hope that you see my screen, and I even will change.
Yes, we can see.
We'll change focus. Still, I have to manage. Give me 1 second. Participants, I want to have my own image. Okay, let's. I should pin. Maybe I should pin my image. Okay. And now I don't see one of them. Okay. Now my image is on the recording. Okay, so derivatives of multivariate functions, gradient and Hessians. And in the lecture, we start with one dimensional example, because we want to settle the notion of differential, which is a little bit special in our course. If I have a nonlinear function and I am staying at the point x naught, I can derive best linear approximation of my function, a linear function which passes through the same point and has the same slope as my original function. And I defined differential, it's increment of this linear function. So I give some increment to my argument dx, and the increment of the linear function is differential. And on this slide, I will show you in a little bit more details. So I am staying in the point x naught, and I built a linear function which has general expression, some constant b plus some constant c multiplied by x minus x naught. And I want this linear function to have the same value at the point x naught as my original function. So I can easily conclude that b should be equal to f of x naught. And I want it to have the same slope. The slope of my linear function is c, and it's derivative of this linear function. So actually, I want this line to be tangent to the plot of original function. So the derivative of my linear function should be the same as derivative of the original function. And then I say the differential is increment of linear function. It's just c multiplied by dx. But c is equal to f prime, so it's f prime multiplied by dx. It's set the basis for our immediate extension to multivariate case. So In multivariate case, for example, in my picture, I have two variables, x1 and x2, and my function f. And also I have some plane, which is tangent to the plot of my function. And I give some increment dx to my variables, and differential function is increment of this plane, of this linear function. So this is a general expression for linear function. Again, it's some constant plus C transpose by difference of x. So C is a vector of the same dimension as x. And again, my condition that at x naught, the function and its linear approximation is the same. So B is equal f of x naught. But now I say, in order for linear function to be tangent to my original function, its partial derivative in every variable should be, should coincide. Its slope, if I move in every way in each variable, the slope on this one dimensional picture of my linear function and of my original function should be the same. And this is this expresses it, the slope of partial derivative of this linear function is just ci, because you see here you have sum of ci xi. So ci should be equal to df by dxi. And of course, differential increment of linear function is C transpose multiplied by dx, which is written here. But I know that C and vector of partial derivatives, it's the same. So I conclude that my differential is vector column of partial derivative, which I call gradient, transpose multiplied by dx. So this is the basis of all our developments. So this is good point to ask questions. If anybody has, I hope that you have. At least those who watched the lecture. If not, then okay, so this is piece of the lecture which actually says the same. The df differential of my function is gradient, inner product of gradient with dx. And now we got notion of partial derivatives and Hessian. I will skip it for the moment, because central point of our lecture is to solve examples. So let's start with example. I will stop my screen sharing. Let me unpin. How do I unpin if I stop my screen sharing? Stop share. Okay. And automatically I will see all of you. And now we will come to the first example. Okay. And I should start my share. Start share. Share. Okay. Do you see my screen? F of x equal to h of ax. And yeah. Now,
yes.
Now I need you, at least you, to be active and open your microphones. Okay. So now our first problem in class, which actually coincides with your homework. We have a rather good lessons we solve partially your homework. So I have a variable n dimensional vector x in Rn. I multiplied it by m by n matrix A. And I have a function h which maps from Rm, result of matrix multiplication, to real numbers. And this is my function f. And I want to develop formula for gradient of f. And I assume that I know matrix A, and also I know gradient of h. And we will go step by step. You know, maybe I will try. I am new with this writing tools, but hopefully I will manage. Let me remove this Hessian. Wow, the removal is not so fast. Any case. So I want to develop gradient of f of x. With this first example, I will show you in initial steps. We will do them together. I will denote, wow, I hope it will work. I will denote this product as u. And I can go into steps. Actually, my goal, given dx, to obtain expression for df. If I will have such expression, then in this expression, I will find the linear dependence between dx and df, and it exactly will give me gradient. So my first observation is that if this is u, what is du? What is increment of u, differential of u, if I give some dx? If
a dx.
So this is a multiplied by increment of x. It's straightforward. You can think delta x. So ax plus delta x minus ax, you immediately will get this expression. My other observation that df, if I know gradient of h, gradient of h, and I know du, what will be df? It's gradient. It's a gradient of this external function multiplied by differential of its argument. I will skip arguments at this point. It's gradient transpose multiplied by du. What remains is to substitute those two expressions and get expression f as df as a some expression depending on dx, and immediately there we will discover gradient. So what I would propose you to do it on piece of paper or on your screen, what you prefer, in Word or in screen pen, if you have such, or if you do on the paper, you can do a picture with smartphone and upload to your computer and show us. So please start working. Still I'm struggling to see all of you. I hope that I will manage. It's not easy to see all participants. Now I will hide. I see. I can pick this corner. Okay. I see that Nam hand, rising hand. If you want to ask question, just talk in microphone, because unfortunately
I accidentally
okay.
My hand.
Okay. So just continue working, and let me know if anybody will write something. It's rather easy and short exercise, and then we will go on. We will continue with Hessian of this function, and so on. So, and by the way, we are recording the lesson, and it may be on YouTube. So if you want your picture to be in public domain, it's completely okay with me. If you don't want, you can close your camera. And I will pause the recording. Alt P. Hopefully it will work. Okay. If I have, if I have U equal AX, what is DU? My function is already linear. So it's increment of my function. Actually, it's not function, it's mapping, but still it's in increment of my mapping. This is A multiplied by X plus DX minus AX. This is increment of my mapping. And of course—
What's the definition?
Yes, definition of the differential is increment of linear approximation of my function. If my function is linear, then of course it's just increment of my function. It's a dx. Okay.
Thanks.
Please. Okay.
Let me know if you see.
Yes.
So I took the nabla on of H transpose du.
This will give you dh. Okay.
Yeah, and then I replaced du with a dx.
Yes.
And then I just put it in the inner product with transpose to know the gradient. Actually didn't continue the compilation.
And what is your conclusion? That gradient is exactly the thing which stays in inner product. Yes. A transpose multiplied by dH. Very good. Very good. Thank you very much. Thank you very much.
Now how I stop the
You can stop your sharing, and then we will move to the second. You know, it's good. We're starting with so simple stuff, but gradually I hope we will get on. Can you stop your sharing?
I'm trying.
It's somewhere on the top left of your screen, or top right, depending. Your Hebrew or English. On the top. And you can stop your also stop your microphone.
Michal, I think you can like take control and mute everybody.
Yes, I can do it. I should find where is my control. Participants. Okay. Okay.
Is that gonna ask?
Yes.
I just want to know when you marked gradient U, you mean you derive U with respect to no U, sorry. It was
yeah, I will show my screen, it will be easier.
Yeah, it's H when you say gradient H, you mean that you derive H with respect to U, right?
Yes, just okay. Gradient with respect to its argument. Yes, gradient of H with respect to its argument. If it would be one variable, I would say is H is sinus, it will be cosine. Okay, but for gradient, it's a little more. But
okay, thank you.
Okay, very good. So now, how can I still new to all these writing tools, I'm trying to get rid to everything that I wrote. No. Okay, where's my eraser? Oh, no. This one? Yeah. It's not so fast. Okay. So we concluded that Nabla F, and I will also call it G of X, and the as in the lectures, G gradient G of X. What we told, it's A transpose Nabla H of AX. Okay, this was the formula. And now I want to develop the formula for the Hessian. And I can write, first of all, I will say Hessian. We want to develop Hessian. And again, we know from the lecture the differential of G, sometimes I will skip arguments. This is H multiplied by dx. So I have expression. I have expression for gradient. Yes. Now my mission is to develop differential of this expression. Again, how can I go? I am thinking about good notations.
Now it's a math, it's a vector now, not a scalar, right?
Yes, now it's a vector. And it includes inside, I will call it, okay. This is Nabla H, yes? And instead of Nabla H, I can call it G. I will denote to save writing is GH. Okay. And I ask question, if I know Hessian of H, if I know differential of its argument, what will be differential of gradient. From the lecture, I know the formula. Again, this is the same formula. I just want to use it for H, yes?
Michael, can you explain, please, why nabla H is equal to GH?
Ah, sorry. I mean, need one more. Or if you want, even put triangle. Oops, sorry. You understand. This is just my notation.
Okay, thanks.
Okay, now differential of differential of gradient of H. This is nabla squared Hessian of H. I skip arguments, multiplied by du. Because H was a function of U, yes? And actually my scheme now is the following. I know what is du, I multiply and I get differential of nabla H, and then I multiply it by A transposes and I get differential of G. So finally, my goal is given dx, get expression for differential of G. Okay, I also have this d nabla H is this, and dg is A transpose multiplied by d nabla H. I just give you all the parts of expressions that you need. You only need to substitute them.
You forgot a transpose.
A transpose, thank you very much. Okay. And now I leave to you just to get everything together and finish it. And you know, yes.
Isn't the differential is an operator that we can calculate only on functions and neither on vectors?
For us, differential is increment. It's like in the lecture. Maybe I show. First of all, I ask you to write down. Actually, I am not sure. Probably I can share several windows at the same time, because for your question, I need maybe to go. Or again, repeat your question. Maybe we will ask an answer without slides.
No problem.
Did you watch the lecture, first of all? My first question.
Yes, I did.
Okay. So differential is increment. It's increment of linear approximation. Yes.
Yes, but when you want to calculate a linear approximation, you can do it on functions, but how can you do that on vectors?
I didn't hear the last word.
How can you calculate the linear approximation on vectors and not on functions?
Linear
approximation is something you calculate only on functions and not on vectors.
Actually, vector may also have increment, yes? And vector also can linearly depend on other vectors. For example, here, you see my mouse?
Yeah.
Here, you have vector nabla H, and you have vector G, which linearly depends on nabla H. So it's very easy. And for example, here, you have vector G which linearly depends. between two vectors may be linear dependent. So it's very obvious that the differential is just the increment.
Michal, the Nabla square h should be transposed in the d Nabla h equal to...
Yes, actually the Hessian is symmetric matrix. So you, if you would write Jacobian in general, you might have to transpose it, but in case
but by definition it was supposed to be transposed, but because it's symmetric it doesn't matter, it's the same.
The Hessian, yes, the Hessian is okay. Automatically by construction the Hessian is symmetric.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
And you know, we are very close to the break. I would propose to meet, I give you 5 minutes for work and 10 minutes for rest. So let us meet in 15 minutes. So in 5:25, we will meet back. And I stop my recording or pause. You want to? Okay, I resumed my repeat from the beginning, please. I resumed my recording. Yes.
We saw in the lecture that the differential of the gradient is the Hessian multiplied by the differentials of x.
Yes.
So so that's the first.
You can just use your pointer. You don't have to mark. Okay.
Right. And then we say that differentials of the gradient is the differentials of a transpose the gradient, and that's equal to the a transpose differentials of the gradient, which is equal to the a transpose gradient square multiplied by du.
Not gradient which, square, Nabla squared or Hessian? Hessian. Hessian of phi multiplied by du. Hessian is a matrix. Yes. Okay.
So it equals to the A transpose Nabla square differential.
Hessian.
Hessian multiplied by x multiplied by differential of x.
Yes.
And as we saw, this is the Hessian.
Yes. And and because by definition, differential of gradients is Hessian multiplied by dx. So what you have in front of dx is your gradient. Is your Hessian. Okay, thank you very much. And very nice expression for the Hessian. Yes, finally, A transpose by Hessian of phi multiplied by A. Okay, very good. Thank you. Who it was? Ida, yes?
Yes.
Okay, Ida, thank you very much. And now we can start with one more example. I should save this one. Okay. And maybe I should learn something more. There is a whiteboard. Yes, there is a whiteboard. I will show you where it is. I don't understand. Did I show? Yeah. Just a second. Whiteboard here it is. Sorry, was my mistake. And okay, our next example is again. I will use the same letters, but with different meaning. I have a function h of x. from Rn to R. And I have function phi. From R to R. And I write it, my f of x is p of h of x. And the same mission to develop, first of all, gradient of f. So again, as we are used, we did denote this as u, yes? You can even use standard notation. And develop differential. So we say that df is gradient transpose dx, yes? Start with the same spirit and develop, please, gradient of my function f with respect to x. Okay, is everything clear? Any volunteer should raise his voice to know that communication is working. Hello? Do you hear me?
Yes. Yes. What was the question?
The question is again gradient of f. First question, and as you can guess, the second question will be Hessian of f. But let's do it one
can way. Can I ask a question?
Yes.
Why did you denote h of h? X is u if hx is a scalar function.
Okay, then u will be a scalar. It's we are starting from new page, yes? Forget about our notation for the first example.
Okay.
So of course we as in previous we know everything about our function h. Yes, we know gradient of h, and for the next question of h is known, and we need to develop gradient of f. And I should learn to. Save. assume recording. I hope that anybody, I see that. did you record all this? So I need to go fast to repeat. So if I assume I have a function of two vector variables, then the linear model, the more general linear representation, a linear approximation of my function has separable form. It's some vector transpose multiplied by increment of u plus some other vector multiplied by increment of v. This is the most general form of linear approximation. That's why if I ask what is differential of f, it's a transpose multiplier. It's the same as differential of my linear approximation. It's a transpose multiplied by du plus b transpose multiplied by dv. And then I assume let u depend on my variable x, which is also some vector, yes? And more than this, I say u of x equal to x and v of x equal to x. And of course, du is the same as dx and dv is the same as dx. And then if I have a function where x is coming in different places, I return to this expression. This will be after substitution. I will get a transpose multiplied by dx plus b transpose multiplied by dx. It is to say that I can freeze my function, say in second variable, and say that only x is changing and get this first term of differential, and then do opposite and get this the second term. And this is what we did in the lecture in the quadratic function. If you have x transpose ax to get differential, first of all, I look on this x as variable and get this term. And then I look on the second x as variable and get the second term. Sorry, I repeated everything because the recording was off, and now I hope that it's working. Okay, now you had the time to digest and maybe ask more questions.
We can think of it also as a matrix, function of a matrix. We have two vectors here. And one of the rows is changing and the other is not. And we can also.
Maybe. Let's leave this open for your investigation, and maybe next time you will comment on this.
Okay.
And
if u, let's say, was depending on only on y, not on x, then is contribution was zero, so we wouldn't have anything on the df relative to x.
Okay, let's discuss it offline. I am not sure that I 100% got your point, or if anybody else wants to contribute to discussion, I will be only glad. If not, then I would suggest to go back to our problem. I stop share here and we'll start sharing whiteboard. Share. Okay. And we told that we have such a chain function p of h of x, where h is scalar function of vector variable and phi is scalar function of scalar argument. And we developed the formula that gradient of f is this expression. It's derivative of phi multiplied by gradient of h. And now we want to go develop Hessian. And now this observation become important. Yes, we can think say about this x as constant and only this one as variable. and develop a differential of this expression, and then vice versa. And try to get differential of gradient, and this will give us question. You can start working, and I will do something quietly, maybe on my part of whiteboard. Any question, any comment? Our class is very interactive because we are moving through very new stuff, and the interaction is very important here. Is everything clear or nothing is clear?
It's clear.
Very good. So start working. Develop differential of this expression.
Yes.
Adi, would the with one term or with two terms already?
With two terms.
Ah, very good, very good.
I think. I hope it's okay. It's correct. I don't know.
I would let me put in this way. We are close to the end of our lesson. Nevertheless, I am used, first of all, anybody who wants to finish. Let us finish, and others can stay or leave up to them. And afterwards, we will have a free discussion with any questions, any comments. Okay, then I stop my sharing. I hope that recording is on. Yes, I stopped my sharing, and you can.
You want me to share?
Yes, if you already have it on your screen, it would be great.
I hope okay. It's correct. I'm not sure. So I use the product rule to open this expression.
Again, we instead of product rule, we say we freeze one variable and analyze okay. the other one. Yes, more yes. general. Yes. Okay.
And then I did a derivative of this expression, multiply by the nabla of h, and then I took it. This is constant and put the derivative on the nabla h, we get the Hessian. And then I opened.
This is the challenging place. It you should have put parentheses. Yes, yes. Go ahead. Go ahead.
Okay. So then I open a d of h of x. It's a nabla of h of x transpose dx. And yeah. then I got the x on both sides, so I took it. So I took the x outside.
Just a second. Can you put your mouse in the middle of the previous line? Line before the last one.
This one.
This one. Yes. You have this strange expression, nabla h transpose multiplied by dx multiplied by nabla h. So it's yes. like rho multiplied by column multiplied by rho. What can we do with this strange stuff? Can we automatically, if I have a product of three matrices, can I automatically get one of matrices out of the product?
But the first part is scalar, right? The first multiplication is creating the scalar, and then
yes, you should have better put parentheses. Does anybody know to draw on the shared screen? I forgot. There is edit create. There is a possibility in Zoom. Yes, to put drawing on the shared screen.
You can annotate.
Does anybody remember how to do it? I did it once and I forget. But any case, you should have put parentheses in this previous line. Nabla h transpose dx, you should put in the parentheses, yes?
Okay.
And then you multiply, this is scalar, you multiply it by vector. And how you open those parentheses? In this, I would like to show my screen. And what was the second part? You already started. Can you finish with the second? Share it again for a few seconds and show us the second part, and then I will get back to the first part more carefully. What was the second element in the sum? It was phi prime. Oh. Yes, phi prime.
Yeah, phi prime of h multiplied by a Hessian of h.
Yes. Why? It will give us the differential of the second term, d of yes. gradient. Yes.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. So the second term is nice. It's less problematic. Phi prime is a scalar. Yes. And nabla squared h annotate at the bottom of the screen. Okay. Do I have annotate? I will need to learn it more. Maybe where I have, no. Okay, I will learn it at home. But we understood. You can help me with your mouse in the meantime. Okay, so it's okay. Yes, phi prime is a scalar. You multiply it by matrix nabla h, and everything is okay. But with the first term, we still need to do some small investigation. And thank you very much. You can stop your sharing, and I will try to show to show my whiteboard. Share whiteboard. Share. Okay. And here I concentrated exactly on this first term. I wrote maybe what you already did. So. I have this dh, which is nabla h transpose dx and phi double prime. And I want, this is only the part. To get everything, I need to multiply by this column, nabla h, which I wrote here. But I put here in parentheses. So I may multiply scalar with a vector column. Can I change the parentheses here somehow to say dx multiplied by nabla h, do something like this? Have I right to do such thing?
No,
because I cannot multiply column by column. Yes, so I do undo on my parentheses. Okay, why it's so strange? Why it's so strange? If I have three matrices, A, B, C, yes, A multiplied by B multiplied by C. I can put parentheses in any order. Somebody should mute microphone. Yes, I can put parentheses in any order if it's legal linear algebra expression. Yes, I can put this A multiplied by B C. Why cannot I do it here? Cannot do it here, yes? And the reason is very simple. If I multiply some, say I have some vector column B and multiply by scalar, let me put it with Greek letter alpha. And say, multiplied by some other vector, say C transpose, yes? Can I write such expression?
Basically, yes, it's out product.
Yes. Why can I write such expression? Because if I look on alpha, not as a scalar, as some separate subject, yes? But as a matrix, y by one matrix, yes? If all three are matrices, then I can put parentheses as anywhere as I want. So is it legal to multiply matrix column by one matrix?
Yes.
Yes, because if I have such a column, yes, I
like you can even move. You can even move the scalar wherever
pictograms.
You want.
I multiplied row by column. Yes, first row by first column. Just row will be one element and column. This is usual matrix multiplication. I have full right to do it. But in opposite way, I don't have right. I cannot write one by one matrix multiplied by column. Can I do it? No, because I cannot multiply row by column. Yes, my row is sus one and column is more than one. So this I cannot do. So the bottom line, in order to have a scalar in matrix expression, when I want to use associativity, if I have vector column, I must put scalar after the vector, not before. And this what I wrote here. I have this scalar. Yes, do you see my mouse? Do you see my mouse? I need to hear some voices. Are you with me? Yes. I have a scalar multiplied by a column. So in order to play with parentheses, I must put scalar after this column. So I take nabla h multiplied by this scalar. And now I have product column and scalar and everything are particular instances of matrices. So with three matrices, I can put parentheses where I want. And here I have right to play with parentheses and get what you got finally. Yes, yes.
So I should have switched the transpose and the...
I guess your final expression is right, but to open parentheses and to close, when you have scalars and the vector matrix expressions, you have to be very careful.
I understand.
And do the thing like I did, but otherwise you did it very nice.
Okay. Understand. Thank you.
Okay. Thank you very much. And now what we can do now? We can stop record. Should I stop recording? Just a second. Stop. I